Hey everybody, this is Head Coach Ross of the Attacks Gym, and I'm coming at you because I received, have my notebook with me to keep my facts straight, and as a result of a conversation I had, I received 89 emails regarding the political discussion, the debate, the presentation by Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump at the Commander-in-Chief a forum hosted by MSNBC last night. And about 10 minutes ago, we just concluded another spontaneous debate involving about 15 of us regarding the same matter. I'm over here at my cousin's or my friend's house. And then I received another 14 emails regarding the same subject, and that's what spawned this video I'm sending to you right now. Spontaneous. So forgive me for whatever visual lapses or what have you we have here. I'm going to try to keep it as tight and as right as possible, and I'm not going to take a long time with this particular video. Let's get right into it. Okay. I took the most common questions and concerns that were raised in the 89 plus 14, 103 emails that I received since the discussion, the debate, the presentation last night by Clinton and Trump, and I answered them here. I also took some of the more notable, unusual, but far less common issues and questions raised, and I'm also answering them. So let's get the notable stuff, the unusual ones, right out the way. The first one is this. I'm pretty well known for debating issues, political issues, social issues, and a wide variety of issues that aren't just so-called self-defense, or at least to most people. And one of the questions I was asked about is, why do I do this? Why do I go to, say, Facebook forums or groups or what have you that are supposed to be dedicated toward self-defense or so-called martial arts, which in and of itself is a misnomer, because martial arts refers specifically to the arts of Mars. So unless you are a Roman who trained in the fighting system of the Roman god of war, Mars, you're actually not training martial arts. So just want you to have that piece of information and recognize what you're saying when you use these terminology. So anyway, I get asked, why is it that I bring up these issues, these political issues, you know, when we're talking about groups of so-called martial arts practitioners? Well, that goes to the ignorance of those individuals who are asking these questions, however well-meaning they are. And most of them are well-meaning. The fact of the matter is this. So-called martial arts is the result of systematically keeping techniques that have worked in warfare and in hunting, and then improving upon those and expanding upon those. The connection it has to warfare is, of course, blatantly obvious. With those who engage in warfare successfully tend to utilize techniques that allow them to defeat their opponent and or kill their opponent reliably. That means they take a collection of techniques which they have tested in war that works, then they systematize it, and that is how you actually create so-called martial arts or fighting systems. These systems have their roots even before the civilization occurred to this extent. When I say civilization, I mean sedentary civilization, wherein farming and what not have happened, so allowed the human population to not have to migrate after food and pursue the food in their migratory patterns. We could basically stay where we are. We could farm the land and feed ourselves that way, and then we could also hunt animals but return to our sedentary location. That's how cities, states, you know, eventually countries and empires were settled and created by humans. So it all starts with hunting, the successful techniques of hunting that were then applied in conflict, political conflict with bloodshed. That's war, all right? And then these things, of course, are the province of the warrior, who is a self-defense practitioner, a so-called martial artist. So you see, you cannot separate the practice of our arts and the history of our arts from war. And you cannot separate war from politics. So wherever the politics are, there's also self-defense. Not only in the physical sense, but also in the mental sense. Even when you're jockeying with other ridiculous politicians to try to pass laws, and you're dealing with the stupidities that come with the back and forth and trade and what have you of politics, whatever your particular ridiculous system is, you know, the trains of war are essential. Okay, that's why I want you to understand that. That's why there's self-defense involved in all of it, and that's why we should be able to bring these things up in various forms. Now, these forms that say we should not do so really are not objecting to the subject matter itself. They're objecting to how some of their members respond to this. The politicized issue is divisive in a lot of areas and to a lot of people. And as a result, you know, just in order to keep making the moderation process as simple as possible, moderators generally forbid political discussion, period. And focus the posts only upon a narrow scope of the subject matter that includes so-called martial arts and self-defense fighting systems. I don't agree with that approach. I think that if you do not address the entire issue, what you wind up doing here is you wind up empowering those who want to make the issue as divisive and as negative as possible. You help them perpetuate that issue rather than cut to the core of the matter, make people be mature and adult and sensible, learn the actual facts, and then apply them in a non-acrimonious way. Okay? All right, so let's get that out the way. Next, let's go right into the discussions with the commander-in-chief, and let's analyze first Clinton's presentation. And the reason why I want to analyze Clinton's presentation first is because she is the one who lost the coin toss to Trump, Mr. Hairpiece, and I'm going to analyze what she says. I'm going to fact check her in my next video, not this one, in my next video, which you'll see up very shortly. And then we'll delve into that, okay? So you have any questions or comments, what I just stated, okay, about the actual history of our fighting systems, our arts. When I say our arts, I don't mean just my family's arts, but the actual history and how fighting systems were created, how it came from hunting, and how the advent of civilized war also required the acceleration, the improvement of the techniques of war and the ways of war, which of course, you know, is our province. You know, please leave any questions or comments you have at the end of this video. Remember to hit the like and subscribe button, because you know we need that. That's how we pay the bills. And please go to my website, Attacks Gym Street Warrior Capoeira at googlesites.com. There are tons of exclusive information there that I just cannot upload to YouTube due to social responsibility issues, and also due to small business issues. I want you to go check out my website so you can get the deals I can give you there, but which will cost me more money to give you on YouTube, and therefore I'm trying to save you as much money as possible, okay? So it's me, Head Coach Ross with Attacks Gym, wishing you a great day. You know, Asante Sana, Ashe.